there is also a growing need to incorporate ecological information and ecosystem perspective in the assessment process. These are, of course, some of the main challenges.
We are from National Marine Fisheries Research Institute in Gdynia, Poland, and we are involved in Baltic Fisheries Assessment Working Group.
The whole assessment actually begins at sea, where we collect the biological materials and the oceanographic data. We process these samples and extract the information required to assess the current status of the stock and predict short-term dynamics. This allows us to provide general advice on future management options. Each step in this process is associated with the uncertainties which need to be considered. I am responsible for the data collection on herring in the Baltic Sea. Some of the assessment models currently used in the Baltic Sea are based on information about the age structure of the stock. To estimate the age of fish, we typically use otoliths, small calcified structures located in the inner ear of the fish. Looking at the visible patterns in these structures, similar to the tree rings, we are able to estimate the fish age.
The samples from the commercial catches are provided by fishermen. But we also collect the data during the research cruise. During the research cruises, we catch two types of marine fish. The demersal fish, like cod or flounder, that live near to the bottom. The second type lives in the pelagic zone of the sea, for example, sprat and herring. I'm an age reader of Baltic sprat. For this purpose, I use otoliths. In a lab, we weigh the fish and measure its total length. After that, we do a more detailed analysis. The sex, maturity, and stomach fullness is determined. Also, the presence of any illness is noted and the otoliths are taken out. By using the numbers at age and mean weights, we can calculate the fish biomass. But also the information from the ecosystem is very important. This data will be used in the stock assessment. We can compare this data with the previous years to know the changes of those parameters during the years.
I am the coordinator of the biggest flounder stock in the Baltic Sea. All countries fishing on that stock are required to upload their commercial data to the ICES database called Intercatch, according to the data code. They upload landings, discards and biological samples stratified by quarter, fleet and subdivision. I get an access to those data and have to check if everything is there. Next, knowing the pattern of discarding practice of each country, I have to estimate discards. Samples from commercial fishery are collected all year round and twice a year from surveys. All commercial data are entered to the national database, but data from surveys are uploaded to ICES database DATRAS. The stock status is evaluated by calculating length-based indicators. Knowing if they are above or below possible reference points, I can assume if the stock is fished sustainably or not.
There is also a growing need to incorporate ecological information and ecosystem perspective in the assessment process. These are, of course, some of the main challenges, but also fields where early career scientists can greatly contribute currently and in the future.